It's back.
It is. We're very excited.
This is a great event. It was a great event before. It had to take a year off, but all things considered, Trista, just being able to do this again.
Everybody, there's just such an energy, and so many of my friends haven't done shows. I haven't done a show in a year and a half. So
no, a year and a half?
One. Yes. And so it's just, I think that there's going to be people coming from all over because they're craving and dying to get out to see things and do normal things like going to art shows.
Yeah, people who like you, who kind of traveled this circuit, this has been a real void.
It has. And those of us who actually make our living from this, it's been interesting too. So
how? I just, all I can think of is how.
I get orders from my website, and there's been a lot of great support along the way, you know, that way, and a little help, you know, with the pandemic unemployment here. Different friends of mine are doing that. And so we're not, you know, I'm doing fine, but it has been different for sure. And it's, good to be feeling back to normal.
Well, and you're so busy usually this time. If you're going to shows, it must, for the last year and a half or so, you've probably been lost.
To a degree, and I will say that some of it has been enjoyable. I got a little caught up on some movies, and I actually was reading a book for the first time in a long time. I'm not normally able to do that. But so I had some time to do things that I don't get to do, and I got a new puppy. I was one of those people that decided to get a new dog during the pandemic. So I've been busy, but not doing my normal creative things. I've been doing some other things that I like to do.
The last time I was in here, I remember you had a huge hunk of clay that had gotten delivered. And we laughed about how you had to carry that stuff around. I really learned a lot about how difficult it is.
It's a lot
for potters.
Nobody has any idea. Dee Leckie, who also is here with me at the studio, she and I always talk about how people have no idea what it takes. Besides, they just see the finished product. They see, you know, you at a show having fun and selling your stuff and feeling good about what you make. But there's so much more behind what we do than what people see.
You told me you were up with your kiln at like 3 a.m.
Yes, I was last night because I've been playing catch up. I had a little bit of a vacation before this, so I'm now making up, and I was loading a kiln up to 3, and then I got up at 6 to load the second one so that it would be ready to fire when the first one finished. That's kind of the life of a potter, though.
So in talking about what we don't understand, because I'm standing here and I'm looking at these because I have some of these kind of things at my own home. To make something like this, how long does it take?
Well, like this piece, I use an extruder and I extrude this out, cut it off, put a bottom on it, put the feet on. That takes probably about, maybe 30 minutes to make it. And then it has to go in the kiln. It's fired. It takes about 12 hours. Then I do all the decorating, the painting of the design with underglazes. Then I dip it in a clear glaze, and then I put it back in the kiln and fire it a second time for about another 7 hours. So all total, in just one piece, it's hard to say because every piece is a little different. Like this one was made on the wheel. The painting is what takes me the most time.
Yeah.
Each one sort of has a hand-done painting that's not like any other.
So you get to see a lot of these kind of things on Saturday.
The
Sophia Street Pottery Throwdown is a great event. And
it's 10 to 5 at 1104 Sophia Street, Sophia Street Studios. We're going to have the Bruce Middle Group playing live music. We'll have some refreshments, water and soft drinks and things to offer. And we're going to have 21 booths to look at. Mm. And see all kinds of a real nice variety of different work.
That's what there's so much there to look at, and it's fun just a window shop.
Yes, it is, and you can start on your Christmas shopping. Some people do.
I have. Yes. I have before a couple years ago.
I want to shout out to Taparillo too. They've been so supportive of this, and she's donating water and lunch for everybody, for all the artists and for the band. It's just, they've been a wonderful restaurant to support this event, and we really hope they benefit also. So I hope people go over there and eat lunch.
The Great Train Race came back last weekend, and that was fun. And to have this back, you just start to feel like, hey, it's happening.
things are happening again in downtown. It's wonderful to see.
Well, and this is a chance too, to, you talk about shopping local. This is where you can shop local and help potters now.
Definitely. You definitely can, and I hope that everyone will.
Yeah, because there's a lot of good, just looking around here, there's a lot of good stuff.
And you think
of
all the booths. And we have a new person here at the studio, Sarah Gray Designs. I want to say, give her a shout out. She's painting furniture, and she finds pieces at sales and repaints them and refinishes them, puts new knobs and then repurposes them, basically. And she's joined me here at the studio. She'll be here Saturday helping me with the shop.
Starts at 10 on Saturday.
10 o'clock.
And it goes until
5.
Till 5.
Yes.
Sophia Street. Don't miss it.